Welcome to the Middle-Earth Shadow of War Gravewalker difficulty walkthrough. I'm excited to be here. I really like the game. I've beaten it on Nemesis, and since then they've released this Gravewalker difficulty, which turns out from the comments, mission accomplished, people are finding it difficult. So hopefully with this walkthrough I'll be able to give you some helpful tips, things that you'll find useful. And as we go through, I'll try and give you commentary throughout on some of the encounters that you'll be facing and tactics that you can use to succeed. With that, let's get started.
I had a family once. A wife.
This is beautiful.
And a son. And I buried them along with everyone I even knew. What has happened to me? Am I dead?
You are banished from death. Cast adrift between the worlds of light and dark. You're bound together, Talion. My life and yours.
Who are you, Wraith?
I shaped the history of Middle-earth. I crafted the Rings of Power.
Celebrimbor, greatest smith of the Second Age. Sauron deceived you into making the rings. He tortured both you and your king.
Perhaps that pain was what led us.
I should have died with my family.
I thought you wanted revenge.
But there is only one way to close the circle. To defeat Sauron.
The time has come for a new ring.
The world of men is ending. I have seen it. I have felt it. In the fires of Mount Doom, a ranger and a wraith, bound together in death, craft the one thing that could challenge the Dark Lord. A ring of power. Power can blind those who seek it, and even the strongest bonds can be broken. The future I have seen cannot come to pass.
Celebrimbor!
Death calls to you again, Ranger. How do you answer?
Where did you find it?
Oh, I still have a few friends left in Gondor. What's wrong, my love?
The past is the past. Nothing can be changed.
We must leave this place. We can go. No.
What do you mean? Lord of Death?
Thank you.
The Wraith calls to you. I call to you.
Wraith!
Where are you?
So this part, if you play before, you know, it's just to learn the game mechanics. You can skip it.
You need to keep quiet.
I am here.
These orcs are preparing for war.
I've spotted the filthy tar!
He's heading into the web. He's a dead man.
I called you here for a reason. I called
you here. You will return him to me. Now.
You are brave. For a man. But it is not your sword that will save him. How much are you willing to sacrifice? To suffer.
I have given up everything.
Not everything. Not yet.
You want the ring?
You would give me the ring for the Wraith.
And find myself beside him in your web.
I am Shelob, and I deal only in truth. I wouldn't give it up either.
Wait.
Time now!
Means something to you.
Go to your puppet before he dies.
rebellion. Her power was vast before, and now you have given her mine. I poured my life force into that ring.
Then we must take it back.
The war you came to fight is not here. The ring is lost. So look to Minas Ethel and the Dark Lord's armies that surround it. Look to the Palantir. Sauron will not stop until all of Middle-earth is dominated.
The Palantir must be protected.
Ethel.
I must know if Shelob's vision holds true.
The spider showed us the truth. Gondor's last fortress in Mordor cannot fall.
Palantir is our concern. We must seize it before it falls into Sauron's hands. With it, his armies will be unstoppable. The fate of the city matters not.
I will not let them be slaughtered like my brothers at the Black Gate.
We need to do something. Taking out the captain should buy the Gondorians some time.
And they could lead us to the Palantir. We must find a worm and make him talk.
So one difference with the other difficulty levels is that the worms are less frequent or less prevalent. So when you see one, you generally want to get in the habit of grabbing the intel while you can. There are three down here, so we'll get all three.
There. His mind is weak. Who leads the search for the Palantir?
The other thing is that the orcs can one-shot or two-shot you in Gravewalker difficulty quite often. So it's better to make use of their weaknesses. So this guy can be dazed by stealth. We'll open with that. He's also immune to arrows, so we want to make sure we pay extra attention to not attacking him with the bow.
The captain leading the search is in the lower city.
Then he will go no further.
Thank you. We will crush the pit's curse. Did you hear that?
Doesn't look good for the Gondorians. We have to help.
The Palantir is a powerful artifact. If we were to possess it,
we could turn the tide.
You should have kept your mouth shut. Now we're stuck back in a rear.
He's close.
The Wraith World will reveal his presence. Zuka.
So again, days by stealth. We'll open the... And there.
The Seeing Stone. No doubt they've hidden it, but we will tear open every room. Enough of your leaping. We're gonna bleed you.
Stop! Break him down.
For Gondor. I will avenge my
Ranger.
Brothers.
This all cannot be stopped. Your brother's here, dead and butchered. And there's nothing you can do about it.
Why are you out here alone?
My raiding party was trapped in the lower city overnight.
How many of you were there?
Not enough.
Innisethil still stands.
We're about to lose the middle city, Ranger. They'll be closing the gate if they haven't already. We need to get up there as fast as we can.
I'll be right behind you.
Wait.
What is your name?
Idril.
Talion.
Don't fall behind, Talion. We've lost enough men today.
Just like Shelob's vision.
If Sauron's forces get from land, all of Middle-earth will share the same fate.
It's not looking good.
It hasn't looked good for weeks.
Sergeant Dagor and his men are at the arena. We must aid them.
Whether you join today or tomorrow.
You made a mistake coming here.
We've lost the middle city. Rally at the gate.
Keep moving. We'll cover your retreat.
And yeah, as you saw, archers in Gravewalker are the game's real nemesis. They can really mess up your day.
Join us! The gate is closing!
We'll be right behind you!
The middle city is lost!
Pulling back! Go! Go!
Where are you going?
Sergeant Dagor, we're pulling back. The middle city is lost.
Not before we finish these filthy drugs. Yes,
they're sealing the gate. Move out. Move out. Have the archers provide support.
They're already dead. Every single one of them.
We've lost the Middle City. We made them pay for every inch of ground, but they now hold it.
Then our fate will be decided here. Our inner wall is our strongest, and we have double their archer.
We cannot match the orcs for their numbers or ferocity.
Now, our people have held back Sauron's forces before.
But some things were lost forever.
Yes, of course they were. Go to the Great Hall. Secure the relics.
My place is here.
And make sure they are taken to Henethanon.
Is that an order?
You must understand. We must protect what is most precious
at all costs.
Yes. That is an order.
Then I'll see it done. But I'll be back on the wall before the next assault.
A ranger from the Black Gates. I heard you were all dead.
You heard the truth.
If you've come to fight for Minas Ethel, Ranger, report to Captain Baron.
Not come to join your army, John. But for the Palantir and its safekeeper.
Protect the city, and the Palantir will be safe. However, our raiding parties are targeting enemy captains in the lower city.
You wish to spread terror in the ranks?
Yes. It's about time they tasted fear.
The men are assembled, General.
We need to secure the Palantir now. The city is weak, and it will not hold for much longer.
But we cannot leave the Gondorians to their fate. Castamir is right. By protecting the city, we protect the Palantir.
Look.
The towers bear his mark.
Those were my towers once. Now Sauron's corruption spreads beyond the borders of Mordor. He mocks me.
They give him sight.
Not without the Palantir.
Dismantle his hold on Minas Ethel. We will shift the tide of war.
These Hydea are but dark imitations of the Palantir. But we can turn Sauron's low craft against him.
These towers can give us sight.
We will purify them and make them ours.
Quicadon the Onthen!
Here we see all that has been lost, and all that will be lost if his corruption is allowed to return. The city is built on the ruins of my kingdom, yet some things remain. Those are my barrows, still hidden from Sauron's sight. There I will show you why we must retrieve my ring. I can show you how to conquer Mordor.
As long as it keeps Gondor safe.
That filthy talk! Face him down!
I recognize this place. I fought here ages ago.
Seems quieter now.
So this quest is pretty straightforward. You just build up wrath and then unleash it with a little elven rage.
If anywhere in Mordor is safe from Sauron, it is barrows like these. Reminders that even the Dark Lord's reach extends only so far. In a bygone age, my army marched on Mordor. We buried our honored dead in barrows like this one. Our greatest warriors are preserved here, protected by powerful magic. And we used all our arts to bring the virtues of the elves with us as we marched.
And you had the One Ring.
Yes. And with it, I forged an army. I led the charge against Sauron. Sauron revealed his betrayal, I took up arms against him. In my wrath, I was determined to punish him for his treachery.
Damn, I was too clever for my own good. Should have just kept on killing forward rather than spinning around to get that guy to the side. But anyway, it's pretty easy to do that mission, so I'll come back and get it later. One thing to note, if you do get gold on all of these, then you unlock a special weapon.
lost for now, but we can still secure the Palantir.
Then we will go to the Great Hall. Idril is there. She may be able to help us.
So since we've received our first skill point that we can freely allocate, now is a good time to pause and talk about building for Gravewalker difficulty. I find that the best playstyle or best build is one that lets me play very aggressively and stay in the middle of a pack of orcs and control the pace of combat. So you can see the first ability that I picked up is Execution, and while Execution is a good ability, and later on you unlock the ability to chain it, what I'm really after here is Grim Resolve. And Grim Resolve not only lets you generate might each time you're hit, so you can really only get hit once, but when you do get hit, you maintain your might, which is hugely important because you need to be able to recover quickly if you are hit. And the way you do that is with the next ability, Consume. So Consume is a really good ability because not only does it slow down combat for a second while you're animating, orcs won't attack you, but you also get your health back, and if you have the next ability, you'll also get Elf Shot back. So that's this one here, Quiver of Souls. Whether you stand there and drain, or you use Consume, or you use Shadow Strike Drain, or Ground Drain, you will get Elf Shot back. And I almost never take this off as well, except for when a mission requires me to be able to dominate orcs and slot the Dominate ability. So this one is almost always on my bar as well. On the theme of being able to maintain your might, this is the next one that I pick up at 13. Mighty Swing is really good, again, for standing in the middle of orcs and being able to generate and maintain might, because as long as you time it properly, then every orc that you hit with your glaive will generate additional might, so pretty handy to have. At level 15, you'll want to be able to pick up Fatal Counter. This one is also really, really handy because you'll see a lot of times you'll get counter indicators on two or three orcs at a time when you're fighting in the middle of a pack, and so this lets you take out all of them very quickly. The counter timer happens really fast on Gravewalker, so usually if you do get a counter off, it's going to be a fatal counter and you'll kill whatever you've countered, so it's very, very useful ability. I usually don't take this one off my bar either. In the process of that, you'll also pick up Elven Light in the next one, which is Ice Storm. And Elven Light is really good because if an enemy is weak to fire or poison, then you can either daze them or kill them almost instantly with Elven Light and its upgrades. So you'll pick this one up in the process of getting consumed, but it's worth mentioning that you'll want to pay attention to the enemy weaknesses and slot whatever upgrade is appropriate for that. At some point, you'll want to pick up Adamant. So Adamant will actually give you one last chance attempt. A lot of times the captains have no chance anyway, so it won't do you any good, but it's worth picking up at some point when you have a free skill point available to you. After you've gotten those abilities, you'll want to work your way up the range tree to get Shadow Strike Pull, and Shadow Strike Pull is incredibly useful. Basically what it lets you do is pull a captain to you on top of a tower so that you can fight him mano a mano and not worry about getting sniped by an archer or having an orc kill you by throwing his hatchet at you, which is usually what kills me in Gravewalker difficulty, so me being able to get a captain, as long as he's not immune to arrows, all by himself so I can take him out, helps a hell of a lot. So I really, really recommend this ability. It's also useful for farming. You can get on top of a Hadier Tower and just pull a treasure orc to you, the white orcs that you see if you're in Wraith Vision. And you can pull him on top of a tower, drain him so you get your elf shot back, kill him, and then look for another one and do the same thing, even from really far away. So, really useful ability, speeds things up quite a bit. And Shadow Strike helps with mobility too. So, great ability to have. And two levels after that, you'll be able to get Ground Drain, which is also good because you'll be able to do this in combat. You do an Elven Light, knock everything down, do a Ground Drain, you get your health back, and you get your off shot back, and then you're usually free with focus so that you can fire off some shots from your bow or your hammer. So it makes it really easy to stay and maintain the pace of combat and control of combat in the middle of orcs. And last, but definitely not least, my favorite skill in the game, and you'll have to complete the Karnan quest to get this one, and I highly recommend you do, just because it's so damn fun. This one obviously isn't about staying in the middle of combat and controlling it. This one is just fucking cool, because you're flying around on a drake, and you can eat captains with the drake sometimes, as long as it's not immune to beasts. You can travel around and get your collectibles more easily. And yeah, this is not a combat ability per se, but it's so much fun, so definitely pick this one up. So I think that pretty much wraps up the build that I go for. Eventually you'll have the skill points to get every single ability and upgrade, but those are the ones that you'll want to get first as you go through the Gravewalker difficulty, in my opinion. So with that, let's get back to the rest of the walkthrough. Okay, so next mission will be the Seeing Stone. The only difference to keep in mind, really, with other difficulties is that for Siege Beasts, you need to hit all four of their weak points before you can dominate. Other than that, it's pretty much the same.
There's no time. We can only take the most value.
We're taking everything.
Idrin, sacrifices must be made.
We'll not sacrifice our past to fear.
Ho there. Who are you?
Baranor, this is the Ranger I was telling you about.
You've spilled much blood for Minas Ithil. We didn't even know your name.
Talion.
Gondor thanks you, Talion. But we need all warriors at the gate.
Well, the Uruks seek the Palantir. They will not stop until it is theirs. Where is it?
My father has hidden it.
There's nothing safe, hidden or otherwise. The Uruks will tear this city apart to find it.
These are desperate times. But we will not surrender, and we will not fall. We cannot.
City fall!
Then we must obtain the Palantir. It is the only way.
Look out!
Beginning. There'll be more. We have to find out what we're dealing with. This way. We'll be able to see the entire lower city once we get there. It's not much further.
City can't take much more. I'll handle the siege beasts.
Baranor and I can manage here.
Talion, we must commandeer one of the siege beasts.
Well, this should prove interesting.
Here they come. Another seed beast is in range. Destroy it.
This siege beast for the enemy.
Pity we can't take it with us. It's a formidable weapon.
We must move quickly.
This should help.
If Minas Ethel falls,
then it will only be a matter of time till they find the Palantir.
I was thinking of Gondor. I know what to do here. These hordes are endless.
Sauron's armies have grown massively. A conventional victory against him will not be possible. We must secure the Palantir.
Another attack will surely follow. We should return to the upper city, check on Idril and the others.
It's not enough for them to destroy us. They wish to wipe away our history.
At least they don't have the Seeing Stone.
The gates are holding.
These relics were my life. My father was right. We must salvage what we can and leave.
You have a valuable weapon. The Seeing Stone gives you sight over your enemy. Use it.
It is too dangerous. The Palantir's poison to men. None can withstand its influence.
I can.
Men before you have thought the same.
And if I'm wrong, I will fail as they have failed. But if I'm right, we win this war.
Then I will find my father. Speak to him.
She will hold you to your oath, Ranger.
You put a lot of trust in her.
Give her time. Until then, we should return to Shelob. I need more answers. We need to see Shelob. Her visions can help us.
We need the ring.
So I'm going to end episode one here, but before I do, I'm going to leave you guys with some homework. What I would do at this point is run around, get the Hadir. So there's one there, the one you have here already, and this one down here. Unlock all of those and find all of the collectibles, the lost artifacts and Shelob's memories and the Ithildin. So collect all of those and you'll get some extra skill points. That's what I'm going to go do now. No need for you guys to sit around while I do that. But I recommend you do so that we're at the same point. And it makes sense to do that for Minas Ithil. I wouldn't do it for the other zones until you get Dragon Song. But it makes sense to do it for Minas Ithil because the only additional mobility upgrade that you can get that'll make it easier is Shadow Strike. And it's not really worth waiting around to get that until later, so you might as well just get them now and get the skill points. The other thing that I'm going to do is do a bit of farming. So for early game farming, you can see that white orc over there. That's a treasure orc, and those guys have gems or currency that you can use and pick up. So what I like to do early game if I want to farm some gems is just stand up here on one of the Hadir. I prefer this one here in the middle of the map. Take out the treasure orcs that you can see. And fast travel back, and you can see I've got my elf shot back, and there are more treasure orcs down below. On the mini-map, you can see them as the white icons. And then once you have several of the gems down below, and you have enough that you feel like you want to go and pick it up, run down, pick it up, fast travel back up to the top of the tower, rinse and repeat until you have all of the gems that you want. So it's pretty quick farming. You'll always have elf shot. If you don't see the treasure orcs, then fast travel back a few times and you should get more. You can use this to get some pretty good gems early on, and while having Shadow Strike pull would make it easier and faster, you know, it's worth getting some gems if you're having difficulty with the subsequent missions. So we'll end episode 1 here, and look forward to seeing you all in episode 2.